What is going on, everyone? Today we are talking about mounts in Ashes of Creation and how exactly you can obtain them, what they do, and more. When you start out in your adventures to the world of Vera, getting a mount isn't something that you will have to wait very long for. It is said that mounts will be obtained through an early quest that is in the starting areas. There is no saving massive amounts of gold and leveling through to get it, but some mounts are a bit more complicated than just given to you or being able to be purchased after your first one, and there are many systems behind how you can obtain mounts and how they work. Mounts will be a physical item in your inventory, so you will summon it, and then when you unsummon it, it returns to your inventory. When you decide to jump on a mount, each one will have different attributes, making mounts more strategic. They will provide things like defensive abilities, resistances, charge abilities, and attacks, along with having varied speeds all depending on the mount. Some of these mounts can even be used in combat with their own abilities, but players will not be able to use their own class skills while mounted. But be careful when engaging in combat because mounts can be killed, although you will be able to resurrect them after a certain amount of time. There are three different tiers to mounts as well. Tier 1 being ground mounts, which is what you get from the starting area. These guys come in all shapes and sizes, and you can even get skins for them that will replace your existing mount's looks but keep the stats it may have the same. A lot of these have been shown off and been able to purchase previously from the cosmetic bundles on the Ashes website as well, but those aren't the only mount skins you'll find in the game. Tier 2 mounts are gliding mounts. Although they can't truly fly, they can give you a nice slow steady glide from a high place and will hover and glide close to the ground as well. Tier 3 are flying mounts. These will be extremely rare and extremely hard to get in the game. Per server, there will only be 10 to 20 players that have flying mounts out of the 10,000 people in the server. You will be able to obtain one if you are a mayor of a metropolis, a king or queen of a guild castle, which also requires you to be the guild master for, or they can be obtained from legendary world bosses. Mounts obtained this way will have a lifespan of 15 to 30 days, which includes the time you are logged out for, but you won't just get to mount it as soon as it drops. These guys, also known as royal mounts, drop an egg and can be brought to life through the animal husbandry profession, and also can be traded to other players once you've brought them to life. This profession gives you the ability to capture and tame animals and breed them. These includes pets, mounts, and livestock, and doing so grants you unique stats on the creatures such as speed, health, armor, and energy. But we will go much more into detail on this system in a different video. Along with these three tiers, there will be aquatic mounts that you can take underwater, and what are called undermounts, which are temporary flying mounts that can be granted to guild officers during a castle siege if the guild castle node is already established prior to the siege. Meaning, if you are a guild looking to claim a castle but don't currently own one, you won't have access to these, but if you're a guild defending your castle, then you probably do. What are your thoughts on mounts in Ashes of Creation? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you were one of the many people who is new to this game and want to jump in on the forums or purchase some cosmetic bundles, then feel free to use my referral link in the description below. Otherwise, be sure to click that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up, turn on the bell for notifications, and stay tuned for a lot more to come.